What's up, YouTube? This is Reverb Triple XP from 8-Bit Co-op, and I want to thank you for joining me here today. I am back. I gotta go back to Ezekiel's grave. I got killed by that giant worm thing because I wasn't paying attention at all, and I was just thinking to myself, I'm like, wow, I was looking at something, and I got my brain kind of like, and I got lost in translation, I guess, and I wasn't paying attention. And by the time I realized, I'm like, it was daytime, I'm like, there's this huge shadow right here. What is it? And I looked up, and I was, like, right in the center of its mouth. I'm like, oh, I was going uphill, too. I was like, oh, well, balls, I'm dead. I didn't even try to, like, run or anything. But I died just right over here. But I was just thinking, what happened was, I was thinking about the... It's very desolate, right? And I was thinking about the solitude and... The solidarity, I guess, of everything. And, we're gonna haul, safely. Alright. But I was just thinking, like, it's gotta be terrible. And, you know, I did find some gold, though, by the way. I think that gold respawned. I'm gonna go get it again. But I was just thinking to myself, like, oh, crap. Okay. I was thinking to myself, like, the vastness of, you know, this planet and just being alone. But it's not, this isn't the type of alone, like, say, you're stranded on, like, an island by yourself. This one is, you don't really have time. Well, I'm not going to say you don't have time, but you're a lot less likely to just sit there and ponder the fact that you're alone and you're by yourself. Just for the simple fact that there's so much... But there's so many hazards and so many dangerous things here that you've got to focus on, that you've got to kind of pay attention to. And I wonder if that guy killed me and he took me underground and I lost my body. Because I believe I was like over here somewhere when I died. I remember seeing that thing and I thought I came up this hill here. I thought I met my fate somewhere around this point. But, I mean, if I can't find it, it's not really that big of a deal. I mean, it is, actually. I'm kind of irritated that I might have lapsed the focus. I zoned out. I was like, man, this place is just... That sucks. This dude's here by himself, and there's nothing. You know, like, what he's got to worry about. You know, he can't have time to ponder. Like, oh, there I am. Well, I died. He ain't got time to ponder, like, oh, man, this sucks. I'm by myself. Because he's got to worry about, he's got to worry about, you know, staying alive and, you know, all the crap on the planet that's trying to kill him. So it's, like, not the same as, you know, if you're completely alone and you have just... hours and hours and hours to just think about how alone you are. You know, it's not the same thing. It's still bad, though. Even though, because there's a time, you know, you're not always going 100 miles an hour. But just think about the fast... Okay, oh, copper, cool. Wait. Aluminum is what I'm looking for. I'll take the copper anyways. Make sure ain't nobody trying to ride up on me. I think I kind of like third person. But just the vastness of it. Like, okay. Space. Think of the most insane number you can think of. Now, multiply that number by itself. And you're still in the infancy of numbers. Like, mathematically. Like, the human mind cannot... wrap itself around the sheer vastness of that space. I remember reading this somewhere. Like, you actually, like, go, you if you sat and, like, seriously, not like, oh, I thought about it for, like, 5 minutes. If you sat and tried to comprehend the vastness of space, you will lose your shit. I remember reading somewhere, like, there's a doctor, like, they were doing a study, like, with, and it was basically, what happened was that P equals NP, and a guy, he, like, was driving himself bananas, like, mentally, trying to figure this out. and he was trying to figure out the vast complexity of numbers, and like how it's like it's never ending. You can always add another zero, and you know, make that number bigger. It's like space. And the dude was trying to figure out P equals NP, which apparently is like supposed to be like the universal math problem. And he couldn't, you know, it's, I think if you do it, you get like $1 million or $10 million if you can figure out this problem. Because it's been baffling scientists for, our mathematicians for, I don't know, forever. But anyways, in the study, they were talking about like the human mind can't comprehend that depth, like that sheer, like there's no end. Like there's no like, okay, it just stops and then nothing else happens, right? Because your brain wants to have a stopping point. It wants to be like, okay, I'm done. And that's what he's saying. The human brain wants to get to a point where it's like, okay, I'm finished. I've done this to the maximum level that it can be done. And because that's how your brain comprehends. Your brain can't, like the human brain, you can, like right now, you go, oh yeah, I know numbers don't end. But if you sat and tried to, you know, figure it, you can't. And that got me, and what it was, the whole article about, when they're talking about the vastness, they're talking about like, there's things that humans have that we probably shouldn't, like the Hadron Collider, okay? And it's, there apparently is a large, there's like a smaller version because they have like a large Hadron Collider. What this is it is, oh, what is that? Okay, we gotta go get that. That's totally not what we're looking for. Oh, these are oxygen. Oh, I remember this place. Anyways, it's, you don't need, what it is it makes black holes. It like slams particles together, and I guess it's trying to create the Big Bang Theory again or whatever. And, or make black, I don't know. But anyways, the point is we have a machine that is we use to try to make black holes. Why? Why do we have this? What possible need do humans have with a device that can create black holes? Because everything we touch, everything we get a hold of, we find some way to turn it into a weapon. If we can weaponize boogers, we would turn boogers into lethal weapons. We would. I mean, yeah, think about it. They weaponize children. I mean, turn children into killing machines, like in Africa and stuff. So we have a device like that they use to slam particles together to make black holes. Why? I don't know. They're just thinking about all that stuff. Like that's where I was going, by the way. That's what happened. I was thinking about that, and I got super distracted. And then I got super killed by that thing. So, okay, yeah, we don't like this. We don't like this at all. Okay, anyway. Back to Osiris. A new Osiris, son. He be hitting the plutoniums. Dude, plutonium is heavy as hell. What? Oh, man. Okay, well, I gotta go back this way. Man, that plutonium was legit. That joint is heavy. Anyways, so we're gonna go ahead and head on back. And so, yeah, I went and got my body. So I'm not distracted. I keep getting these phone calls from New York. I don't answer them. I don't know anybody in New York. I don't. One of my fondest memories when I was in the Marines was I went to New York with some friends. And we were trying to figure out where we were and what time it was. We were trying to get to the Times Square because I had never been to Times Square. I wanted, you know, see it. So my friend, who is from Boogie Down, he's from the Bronx. And he was like, yeah, no, I grew up. It's like, I was born in the Bronx. I grew up here. And then when I was like 4 or 5, we moved. So he's like, I was born in New York, but I'm not like from, you know, I'm from New York, but I'm like from New York. Like, I can't, you know, he moved from New York to like, I don't know, freaking, it was something weird, Delphia Plains, South Dakota or some crap like that. He went to South Dakota, basically. I was like, okay, yeah, this is the furthest from New York. I mean, and that's where he grew up. So he didn't know, you know, he was like, yeah, I'm from New York, but I'm not from New York. So we were walking around, and we were like, okay, we're like super lost. We need to ask somebody something to find. Oh, titanium and copper. I'm gonna get some titanium. What is that? Oh, oxygen. I'm gonna drop some of this and get some titanium because I would like titanium. And I know, oh, there's a bunch of nodes here. What? Okay, yeah, we're gonna drop some of this copper, titanium. Anyways, so Jesus, drop that. So I was this guide, and I'm like, yeah, I'm gonna go ahead and ask this dude. Really? Really? What? Jeez. Good night. I have a feeling we're gonna need titanium for something. But aluminum is what I need, and I'm not finding aluminum. So this is past that spire right there to the left of Ezekiel's crater. So we got plutonium, titanium, quantifibularium. Anyways, so I was like, we were like, yeah, let's ask this dude here. Like, hey, you know, Sergeant James, ask that dude right there, you know? So I'm like, hey, and the dude was like, yeah. He looked like, honestly, when I seen him, he was sitting on the bench, and he had a newspaper. He was, and I'm like, my first thing was like, okay, this dude looks kind of bummy, you know? I'm looking at him, and I'm like, in my head, I'm like, it doesn't seem like a good plan. That dude does not look like he would be the type of individual that you could just run up and start asking questions. But I was like, you know, and it was because they hit me with the, oh, there's some aluminium. They hit me with the Sergeant James. So I was like, all right, Marines, I gotta go take care of Marines. So I, oh, no. So I was like, hey, excuse me, sir. I didn't realize dude was asleep. I didn't realize dude was, like, yonked, too. This dude was straight up yonked. He was gone. I don't know what he got a hold of, but whatever it was, he was deep into the pills or the shots or whatever. And dude jumped up and punched me. Like, I'm not even joking. I'm like, hey, excuse me. I guess I startled him. He woke up, punched me, and then took off. I'm not even making that up. Like, he straight up stole on me. And I was so like, oh, what the hell just happened? I didn't even like, and you know, the Marines, I was like, oh, what the hell just happened? I'm like, dude, and it scared me because I think my problem was I shouldn't have touched him. And that's why I put my hand, I was like, hey, excuse me. Because I was like, hey, you know, hey, what's up, yo? I excuse me, sir, you know. He wasn't responding, but he wasn't like, when I looked at him, his eyes weren't closed. Like, it looked like he's like somebody you're looking, they're looking down, their eyes are half closed, and like they're reading. I swear this guy was like reading the paper. So that's my memory of New York. I got punched by a crackhead bum in the chest piece. And all I wanted to know, like, hey, can you tell me what time it is? Because we need to find. We were trying to get on a train or something to get to. We were trying to go to Times Square. Trying to go to Times Square. Never been. Never went either. Never got to go. I got punched in the chest with a bum, and I'm like, I'm done. I'm done. Screw New York. New York can kiss my ass. I'm never coming back. And I tell a lie. I did go back to East Rutherford. I don't know if East Rutherford, that's not, is that New York? Is it? Yes, no? I don't know. To watch the Patriots play, and they beat the crap out of them. I watched the Patriots play the Jets, and the Patriots kicked the crap out of the Jets. Anyway. So, I'm getting a phone call from New York. I'm like, yeah, I don't want to answer that. So I might answer it, and some dude might reach the phone and punch me in the chest. Like, that's what time it is, bitch. I'm not trying to hear all that. Punch me in my chest again and see what happens. Probably the same thing that happened last time, but I'm going to sound tough about it. I'm going to sound tough like I'm finna do something now. You punch me in the chest, see what happened again, fool. Before you get handled, be touching my chest piece like that. Dude, punch, it stole on me too hard. It hurt. I cried a little bit, a lot. I cried some. Shut up. I'm talking to him. I don't even like y'all no more. I'm done telling y'all stories and y'all just gonna make fun of me. Alright, you got a punch in your chest. You a punk ass. Only punk ass is punched in their chests. In their chests. I don't know if I ever told you the story about the breath. I'm not okay, I'm not like dumb or illiterate, but for some reason, I need, oh, I did, I copper. Okay, let me get my copper in, okay. But me and my wife were talking, and we were talking about pluralization of words. And she was like, the pluralization of breast is breasts. And I'm like, that don't sound right. That's like breasts. There's oh my God, I took all. Oh, anyways, I'm like, there's too many like letters in there. Like, no, it's breasts, isn't it? And I don't know why I was thinking this. I was like, I'm not even trying to be funny. I legitimately thought like I was speaking on some knowledge, like I was right and she was wrong. I'm like, no, it's breasts. It's like two, you add an S to it, right? And I don't know why my brain was just, it's like, no, we're gonna be stupid today. We're just gonna make you look as dumb as humanly possible today. And I just sure as shit, I tried to convince my wife that the plural for breast was breasts. And then she was like, no, think about what you said. Think, stop and think about what you said. And then when I sat and I thought about it really hard, I'm like, oh, I sound dumb. I'm dumb. I'm stupid. Like, oh man, she's gonna leave me now. Dang, I can't even get mad. I can't get mad if she leave me. Like, you know, yeah, we're done. You're stupid. You breasts? Really? Breasts. What the hell's a breasts? Like, you can't make this stuff up. Can't make this stuff up, guys. Can't make this stuff up. These are the things that happen to me. These are the things. Okay, so now we're gonna make a structure. We're gonna make this. Ooh! Okay, first of all, this is way bigger than initially. This is bigger than previously indicated. This is ting ting. Oh, it's ting. See. Where's how do you Okay, first of all, there's my base. I want to put this as close to my base as possible. That's the entrance. Okay. Confirm, build a habitat. Get a habitat, bitch. Look at the, oh, I like it. Look, look, look. That's neat. All right. Okay, so habitat overview, owned by me. You ain't gonna let me. I did all that and I can't even get in. I can't even get in. What was that overview thing? Maybe I should go over there and see what that was about. Let me put all this stuff up and I'll see. Shovel. Okay, well, I'm gonna put this in there. Put that in there. See, I'm gonna put my water in here too. I don't really feel a need to carry that around, just for the simple fact that I don't need. I don't feel I don't need it. That's it. That's my only reasoning. I don't want it. I don't want to carry it around. It's gonna clog my inventory. All right, store an inventory. No, wait, hold on. There's something else I want to get rid of. I want to get rid of this class. Store inventory. And all right, I got my duct tape and everything. All right, let's go see habitat overview. Owned by me. Okay, so I can't get inside. Why can't it? Oh. Well, this sucks. Well, what do I do now? Repair. Oh. Okay. Right. So, I have no idea. No idea what to do now. So I build my habitat. But furniture, maybe? Fabricator. Chemistry table. Maybe I need to. Okay, chemistry table. What was it? I need 5 steel and 10 glass. Okay. So, whoa, what was that? Whoa, what was that? What's that?
Oh.
Oh, you can't get to me. Oh, that's really gotta piss you off something ter- Oh, he's got ups. But you still can't get to me. I'm gonna shoot you and get some free XP. Tyranid. Gonna kill some Tyranids. Oh, there you are. Oh, man. Oh, there you are. Wow, you're quick. Good lord. Skitterer, man. Man, that thing's quick. You can't come in. You can't come in. Your access has been denied. Okay, so I got close to here. Oh, no, there's more stuff. More stuff. You? No, I killed you. Okay, that sounds big. That sounds huge. Oh, it's one of these things. Oh, ooh, he's spinning. I think I like third person better for combat. Okay, so multitude. Let me fix my. Oh crap. Oh wow. Okay, normal wall. So, oh, that's neat. Okay, so I need iron, copper, and aluminum. Okay, is it safe to go out? Even if it's not. Okay, so I figured out how to do the walls. Figured out how to do my walls. And we're gonna go up in here and we're gonna save it real quick. And oh, wait, wait. Oh, get your squist. Oh, okay. We're gonna go back in here. Alright. Is that new? Oh no, it's just. I guess I'm just looking at them differently. Your little spit doesn't seem to do. Your loogies don't seem to do much damage. So, yeah, I'm on your planet. Rocking you, by the way. Rocking you, because. You know, mankind and everything. Ka-twinge! I apologize if it's loud. I only have my thing on. I turned it down to 4, but it was only on 6, and I realize now that might have been too loud, and so I might have just made some people. Hey, he runs funny. He runs like one of them little lizards. One of those little frilled lizards that run on their back leg. I should be. This is wild. There's so many. I mean, not that I'm complaining. I like this. I actually like. I have something to do. I feel like I might. And I'm cheese mode protected. So, You guys can't. I don't know if that's if this is a bug or. I do like the mid. They're too big to fit in between there. Maybe. And oh. Get some. Hell yeah. Okay, so. Alright, so this episode, we're gonna get some stuff done. We're gonna get some stuff done, guys. Okay, so. I wanna grab. It was copper, wasn't it? Copper, aluminum, and glass, I want to say. I'll see. I may be wrong. I actually think I am. Okay. What is that? Iron. I need iron. Iron foe. Oh, iron foe. Oh my god. Oh, iron foe. I missed you. Okay, add the back. Alright, so gotta get some walls put up. Okay, windowed wall. Let's see. The very back, I want a windowed wall. Definitely want a windowed wall in the very back. Alright. Yeah. Now we are making progress. Alright, get my windowed wall up. So I can see outside. I want front, back. Okay, boom, boom, boom. Want this to be a windowed wall as well. And bloom. I like that. That's a gratifying sound. Bloom, bloom, when you finish something. Okay, and I don't have much aluminum, so I know windowed wall. That one's gonna be a windowed wall. So we're gonna make this a normal wall. Nice. Now, do I have to do a roof, or is the roof automatic? That's got me curious. It's got my curiosity piqued. Ka-ching! Alright, so. I don't think I have enough to do anymore. Oh, no, I tell a lie. I have enough to do one more wall, and then we're going to be out of aluminium, and I'll have to go farm some more, but I'm going to go ahead and end the episode now. My name is Third Battalion. Thank you for joining me in this episode of Osiris, A New Dawn. We're making progress. We are making progress. We got things built, and I'm going to go and get some more aluminum so that we can... Is that aluminum right there? Huh. Yeah, I'm going to get some more aluminum and make our walls, and I will see you guys in the next episode. Take care.